Right, next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have amateur K1 over 3 2-minute rounds in the lightweight division. Would you welcome first into the blue corner, representing Stronger MMA, Jonah Harrison. And would you welcome his opponent into the red corner, representing Lightning MMA, Tom Gladwell. Your referee, Mr. Sam Amidi. Three 2-minute rounds of K1 action in the lightweight division. Jonah Harrison, Stronger MMA, in the blue corner. Tom Gladwell, Lightning MMA, in the red. White shorts predominantly for Tom, the slightly shorter of the two men at the weight. Jonah in the all black with the silver trim will have the height advantage. First round kick, and then the left hand got Jonah's attention there.
That was
from
nice.
Tom
again looking for that counter. It's beautiful.
He's looking for a sharp left hand counter from the round kick.
Oh, nicely timed
side kick to the midsection, perfectly balanced. Switching naturally from orthodox to southpaw to work the legs that he wants to work.
Beautiful.
And it's a good start, Rob, from
Great
Tom.
Combinations.
That said, a good uppercut there from Jonah as he came in close. And the left landed cleanly again.
It's a beautiful teeth he's got.
Well, the thing is, Jonah's landed with two very good boxing techniques, but Tom's happy to stay in the pocket and still trade with him to get his own shots going. He's not been worried about that height and reach. Good teep there, though, from Jonah. Nice, balanced opening round, Rob. Two very
done.
Quality men here. And there's what I'm saying about staying in the pocket. You can see the height advantage when they're directly above us, but Tom will stay there with him. And that's why, so he can land that right hand cleanly. Jonah took that well. Made nothing of it.
Beautiful.
But that was a good shot. It was a beautiful right hand.
Yeah, it was a nice work. As you said, just the closing of the distance. Again, beautiful work. Nice combinations.
Doubled up those kicks. And all he really wanted to land was that straight right hand, which he did as the third technique. This is a good quality affair, but I've got to be honest, Tom Gladwell was catching my eye there overall. Two good men, but Tom for me, controlled the range despite his opponent being taller.
Yeah, I mean, he was a more successful in that first round. Definitely some beautiful, clean techniques. But that's to take nothing away from Jonah. Landed some lovely techniques of his own. But as you said, it's just that, the little things that Tom's doing and
it's
doing
margins
well.
With between these two, Rob. And I mean, as I said, Jonah landed a beautiful little uppercut and a left hand. But it's what he took back, what Tom was willing to take to give back. And what he was willing, I mean, the perfect one for me was right at the end of the round. Low kick, high kick. Really, all he was thinking was then the right hand's coming through. And that's what landed really cleanly. It's just margins, but those margins for me are in favour of the red corner at the moment.
We move towards the second round, and usually this is the point when I sort of say what I thought, think a quarter and I might have said, but in this fight, you know, it's so possibly evenly matched, they're both doing everything right.
Yep, I mean, it's pure K1 in the sense that there's been no clinching. Sam hasn't had to stop them because K1, it's clinch, strike, release, but we haven't seen the clinch or strike. We haven't really seen the knees come into play too much at all here. And that could be something that might come into this second round. But again, the mobility of Tom catching the eye there, the first knee comes in from Jonah. And this could be vital and a nice cheap. Now he's finding the range himself. This is.
I was just about to say that. He seems to have found his... Oh, and as we said that, Tom clips him with a left hook that nearly sinks him.
And
great
Tom knows.
Resilience.
He knows, look, that's why he's really upping the pace here with the boxing now. That left was sweet. And for me, it was just as Jonah was getting into a nice groove.
Yeah, definitely. He was just finding his rhythm.
He was finding rhythm, he was finding range, and then that left hand came out. Well, he's absorbed it well. He's back in the groove. He's boxing nicely.
That was a nice straight right he landed there. Tom's got great movement. Again, just pops that foot out. Not any real danger. It's giving Jonah something to think about.
Jonah bobs and weaves and comes forward with a straight left. Cheap to keep the range. And again, I like the way that Tom doesn't just sit and admire the kick. When the high kick comes in, he uses it to close the gap and throw the punches. He doesn't just say, look at that, what a wonderful high kick. Jonah stays in the pocket, stays focused. He took that shot well and a nice right hand of his own. He's still very dangerous. But what he's got to watch is the hooking counters in close. As I said to you before, Tom's willing to allow Jonah to come in to get those hooks off. And he's taking shots here. These are scoring shots from Jonah. But you feel that Tom's taking them to get those short, sharp hooks. Better round from Jonah.
Much better. Much cleaner. There was a big shot that almost wobbled him. Needs to be very careful, those hooks, as you said, Malcolm. The hooks come in, come over the top, they're very, very dangerous.
The difference for me in the second round was Tom took more to get where he needed to be, and it actually worked in Jonah's favour. Whereas before, we saw that he was happy to let Jonah close the range, but he worked a lot faster. I think in the second round, it didn't quite work as well. I'm not saying it didn't work at all, because we saw that wonderful hook.
Yeah.
But Jonah managed to get more clean scoring shots off than Tom allowed him in the first round. But Rob, it's a beautifully clean K1 bout. Sam's not had to split them at all.
That's right, as you said, one clinch, one knee, and they parted separately, separated nicely. Very technical.
Third and final round, they touch gloves. The round kick from Tom to start, throws it again to the midsection, and there you saw what Tom's waiting for. He was sharp with the shot there, Jonah, needed to be, because the left hook came back instantly.
Yeah, Tom pressing forward, But Jonah happy to.
These are good straight punches. Counter.
Good kick to the body.
That was solid.
It got a nod of respect.
Tom's bleeding from the nose as well. Those are the straight punches. And this is what he did in the second, Jonah. He's come back very strongly. Nice block of that kick, and it needed it. Jonah's grown in confidence, and this third round, he's really starting to ask questions now.
Yeah, he's taking the fight to his opponent comfortably now. Good clinch, one knee.
And the sidekick, not with the precision and the crispness of previous rounds. Jumps in, but again, this time, it's Jonah steps off the line and throws the right hand counter. This is a big start to the third round from the blue corner.
Yeah, very different to the first.
And moments in the second. I thought he grew in confidence in the second, and he's really asking questions of Tom now here in the third. Skips that hook, look, and then throws his own left back. He's in the zone here, beautiful left of the body, and his corner, they're the happiest and the most animated they've been in the back because he's found his range and rhythm here in the third. And again, the little combinations coming forward. And slips that right from Tom this time. The difference is Tom's not landing as cleanly as he was, especially in the first.
Yeah, his counters aren't as clean. He's not landing as clean. The combinations aren't there.
The right knee came from... That was a big, big third round for me for Blue Corner.
That really was. So, first...
First we had red.
First for red. Second.
Third, I say blue. So let's be honest, if we're going to sit on the fence, Rob, it all for me depends on how the judges score the second round. I think you could make a good case for Tom in the first. You make a good case for Jonah in the third. That second, for me, is key.
That'll be the decider. Over to the judges.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a cracking bout that was. Three superb rounds, please. Let's hear it for both your warriors in the cage. And these two men have taken us to a split decision. But that decision is in favour of the red corner, Tom Gladwell.